Hello guys. So I've been having a lot of questions about bridgeless mode, not only from people on social media, but actually from clients who are trying to update their apps, migrate their apps. And I thought I would just make a very short video, try to explain on a very easy manner what's this migration about. So if you're familiar with React Native, over the last few years there has been quite a lot of changes. The core has been migrating to the JSI, to C++, to a more native communication. And on those lines, Bridgeless is the next step in the evolution of React Native, where the core team is finally getting rid of the old JSON bridge, which means everything will now be native communication through the JSI. So there's this post which explains on a very high level what it actually means, or not a high level, but more detail, what does it mean for native modules, for the native renderer, for fabric, and all this kind of stuff. You can take a more detailed look if you're interested in there. But I thought maybe a visual explanation is a little bit better. So as you know, or maybe you don't know, React Native started with the JSON bridge, which basically handled all the communication between JavaScript and native, right? Your JavaScript would serialize your state of the UI, whatever commands or whatever functions you wanted to call from the native side into JSON. They would get handed over to the bridge, where you can just think as an instance, as an object that handles this communication, and then the bridge would then call the native functions themselves. So the big idea behind the JSI and doing these native modules migrations is that this was slow, right? Stringifying everything. This became a bottleneck where there was a lot of things going on, where UI had to update, where you needed to call native modules, where you had a lot of data. So the entire idea is just to replace, to get rid of this, right? And once you have that, this gets replaced with the JSI. Now, in order to keep the apps working over the last few years, actually this wasn't completely removed, like the bridge was still there. And it was kind of running in parallel with the JSI. The JSI is not an object on its own, right? It's just a bunch of headers and functions that allow you to call native code. But basically, all the old modules would still work even if you had the new architecture turned on. This is, of course, not maintainable because it requires a lot of work to keep both of the systems running and working. So basically, the idea is then now to get completely rid of the JSON bridge and just, you can even think of it more like on the lines of there's nothing standing between your JavaScript and the native code. So this is going to bring, let's say, improvements, maybe not immediately because nothing changes immediately, but rather on the long term, the core team can iterate on more native functionality, synchronous APIs, and this kind of stuff. Now, if you have an old module, you do want to migrate to Bridgeless. This has been an ongoing work from the community itself, because a lot of packages are, from different players in the community, Expo, Magello, some me, myself, whatever, whoever has a package that uses the old APIs using the bridge, they need to migrate to the bridgeless mode eventually. But for now, the old modules are still going to work with this thing that's called an interrupt layer, which basically allows the all declarations that we had that use the syntax, the macros that we used to declare the old modules to work with this new bridgeless mode. This will eventually go away. It will definitely stay for this year, but eventually all the modules will need to be migrated to turbo modules, which work on bridgeless mode. But for now, your modules should more or less work. Maybe you need to do a little bit of work in there. So it's just as a heads up, if you have your app and you depend on some of these modules which are not migrated, then at some point either you will need to migrate them yourself, or the author needs to migrate them, or you need to look for an alternative. All right. Also would be good to mention a new tool, which is this new Arch helper package from Alexio. I don't know how you say it. But in any case, this allows you to run it inside of your application, and it will tell you which packages are ready to be used in the bridgeless mode. Now, this doesn't run anything against the package itself. There's an Excel sheet somewhere where all the authors, all the maintainers of different libraries we have contributed and declared if our library is working or not. But this definitely does give you a good sense of which of the libraries you're depending on are ready to run on the new architecture and on bridgeless mode. Very, very useful. So yeah, basically, that's all about bridgeless. Again, you can read more details in the actual post from the team. You can try to turn bridgeless mode on your app, see if anything explodes. It will most likely explode if you have a fairly large app. You will be depending on a lot of old modules. But this is the path where things are going. I'm very excited to see what changes this brings in the future. And yeah, I'm available for freelance work. Not right now exactly. But yeah, get in touch. Follow me on Twitter, also on YouTube, and see you next time.